Hi everybody, thanks for stopping by my page. Let's get cooking till Daddy's in the kitchen. Today on Daddy's in the Kitchen, I'm cooking honey grilled shrimp with roasted corn relish, cilantro rice, and spicy creme fraiche. Now, I don't know if I'm pronouncing fraiche right, so you might have to look that one up. This recipe comes out of the Hell's Kitchen cookbook. It's a pretty good cookbook, has a lot of recipes that are very good in it, and some of the recipes are very aggressive and it requires a lot of detail. But I like it, so if you have a chance, dig into it. You might find some stuff in there that you like. So I'm going to get some of the prep work done, and then I'll come back and show you how it all looks before we start.
Welcome back.
And as you can see here, I've done some of the prep work. I have all of the things that I need to get started with the shrimp, and also cut off the kernels off three ears of corn. So I'm ready to roast the corn to get ready for the roasted corn relish. The shrimp is here. I also have some red peppers that are chopped, and in these red peppers I did not include the seeds or the little white parts that's on the inside. That stuff makes it very hot. I have a jalapeno that's chopping, but with that I did include the seeds. Here I have three cloves of garlic that have been chopped, a chopped up tomato, one small white onion, and these are the things that I get ready for the shrimp. But I'm also going to roast the corn to get ready for the roasted corn relish. So here you can see the shrimp. It's been marinating overnight in a mixture of chipotle peppers, and the chipotle peppers comes in an adobo sauce. That stuff is very hot. I also chopped up three cloves of garlic and put those in here. It has some crushed red peppers, it has honey, and it has a little bit of lime juice to add some kick to it. The other things here will get added into the skillet. Now the shrimp calls for me to grill the shrimp, but I'm cooking this entire dish inside, so I'm going to sear the shrimp on the stove, and then I'll add these other items as well. While I'm searing the shrimp, I'm also going to roast the corn, and that'll be the main part of the roasted corn relish, and then I'll bring you back so you can see how I combine the things to make roasted corn relish and how the shrimp turns out as well. So now what I'm doing is I'm going to take the corn and get it ready for roasting. I took the corn, I put in 2 tablespoons of olive oil, seasoned it with salt and pepper, tossed it around a little bit, and now I'm going to spread it onto a baking sheet so that I can bake it at 450 degrees for about 20 minutes. Try to spread it out so that it's on a single layer. Should take about 20 minutes. And now let's get this into the oven. The oven is already at 450 degrees. I'm going to place these on the bottom rack. Let those stay for about 10 minutes and I'll check them to see if they're brown. And then I'll just stir them up a little bit, get them turned over for another 10 minutes. And then they should be good to go. All right, let me get this right started. Got my saucepan. Get it started on a moderate heat. Add 1 to 2 tablespoons of olive oil. All right, that oil high and hot. Now I'm going to add the onions. Two cloves of garlic. Chopped serrano pepper. While those onions and garlic and peppers are cooking for a while, 4 to 5 minutes, I'm going to check on the corn. Like it's nice and toasty on one side. These onions look like they're about right. I'm gonna add the rice. This is 1 cup of rice. I need to get that coated in the oil and let that cook for 1 to 2 minutes. Now the rice has been cooking for about 2 minutes. I'm gonna add the chicken broth. That's 1.5 cups of chicken broth. Once I get the chicken broth in there, I'm gonna turn up the heat to bring it back to a boil, and then I'm gonna let that simmer for a while. While that's simmering, I'm gonna chop up some cilantro because that has to go in here as well. All right, so now the rice is finished and it's just sitting over there off of the heat. Now I'm going to make the cilantro puree. I'm going to take the cilantro, garlic, the remaining serrano pepper, some ground cumin, and some olive oil, and I think that's about it. And I'm going to put all that into the food processor, which I'm using my NutriBullet, and I'm going to make the puree, and then I'm going to add that to the rice. We'll see how that goes. So that's 1/3 cup of olive oil, 1/2 teaspoon ground cumin. Hopefully I'm saying cumin right. The remaining serrano pepper, the garlic, and then the item that's going to make the dish, the chopped cilantro. I'm going to chop that into or put it into a puree. I need to add a little salt. Cilantro puree into the rice. Stir that up well. Okay, so now I'm gonna make this crimson friace, which I'm almost positive I'm pronouncing wrong, and I'm not even gonna make it right. Because I couldn't find crimson friace, but I looked up a substitute for crimson friace, and it is sour cream. So I'm gonna make the sour cream, and hopefully it'll come out very well. So I have a 1/4 cup of sour cream. I need a 1/4 teaspoon of lime juice. I'm gonna add a little extra lime juice. Small amount of chopped jalapeno pepper, finely chopped. I think that came out to 1/4 tablespoon. It asks for a pinch. Cayenne pepper. Small amount of ground cumin. And then I'm gonna stir this all together very well. Now the final piece that needs to be cooked is the shrimp itself. So the shrimp again has been marinated for quite a while, hopefully it retains that flavor. I'm gonna heat up a skillet, I'm gonna add some oil to it, a slight amount, and then I'm gonna sear the shrimp about 1 to 2 minutes on each side, and then it should be ready to go. Add a little bit of olive oil. All right, so the oil is heating up. Let's add the shrimp. All right, the shrimp is done, and it's time to plate the dish. Look at that shrimp, lovely. Now imagine it would have turned out a little bit different had it been on the grill. Maybe it would have had some different coloring to it, but it's still looking pretty good. And the smell is amazing. All right, so the dish is ready. I've got the dish plated. I'm gonna show you the final dish. I wish there was a way to get the aromas into the camera, but you're gonna have to try the dish so you can smell it all and taste it all. So here's the dish, final dish plated.